माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर ऑल वेल बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ ऑलमाइटी अल्लाह। ए लॉन्ग पीरियड वी आर एब्सेंट इन स्टडीज, सो वी हैव टू गो टू discuss our teaching or our class or lesson parts of speech. I am Sushant Kumar Roy, assistant teacher, SM Model Craft High School, Gopalganj, for class 6 to 10 English second paper. Now we are going to discuss parts of speech. What is called parts of speech? Part, that's mean ongsho. Parts of speech. Speech, that's it, sentence. Every part of a sentence is called parts of speech. Now another sense, what is called parts of speech? The different classes into which words are divided according to their functions in a sentence are called parts of speech. Now look, I saw a bird. Here, I, one part, saw, one, another part, and a bird, another part. There are three parts in this sentence. This is parts of when words are classified accordingly to what work they do as small parts of a whole sentence, they are called parts of speech. Parts of speech. How many parts of speech? Parts of speech. Eight kinds of parts of speech. Noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Now we are going to discuss, today we are going to discuss noun. What is called noun? Any name is noun. Any name is noun. Any name, that's mean Kurim, Rohim, Ram, Sham, these are noun. Nouns are names of people or persons, places, things or quality. Another, a noun is the name of a human, object, place or action. Another, a noun is a word which denotes the name of a person, thing, place, quality and condition. These are noun. Classification of noun. Basically, two kinds of noun. Abstract noun and concrete noun. What is abstract noun and concrete noun? Abstract noun. An abstract noun is the name of a quality, action or the state of an object. Now look, abstract, basically in a sentence you can find, after a word you can find nest, hood, dom, sheep, ing, illness, such as illness, ness, that is illness, hood, that is boyhood, dom, wisdom, ship, scholarship, or friendship, or relationship. These are abstract noun. Next, concrete noun. A concrete noun is the name of the something which has bodily existence and can be received through sense organs. Organs, suppose I touch my head. Here, head, that is organs. Now, how to concrete noun? Now look, seen, smelled, touched, test. You can see anything, that is concrete noun. You can smell, that is concrete noun. You can touch, that is concrete noun. You can taste, that is concrete noun. So, suppose I saw a bird. I saw a bird. This is concrete noun. This is concrete noun. But when we cannot touch, smell, seen, taste, these are abstract noun. Concrete noun, four kinds of concrete noun: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, and material noun. Proper noun, common noun, collective noun, and material noun. Proper noun, what is proper noun? Proper, that is person, things, places. These are proper noun. Common noun, a common noun is the name given to all things and persons. Collective noun, a collective noun is the name of a group of similar things or persons taken as a whole. Material noun, a material noun denotes the matter or substance of which things are made, that is iron. Proper noun, proper noun, only one name, any only one name, suppose Padda, Padma, this is a one name. Crow name, Rahim name. Now look, this is a chart. Proper, common, and collective. What is different? Proper, common, and collective. River. River, that means all over the world. River, that is a name. This is common noun. But Padda or Surma or Jamuna or Meghna, this is proper noun. But only river, river, that is common noun. But Padda, Meghna, Jamuna, Dhaleshwari, Budiganga, Adiyalkha, this is proper noun. Then collective noun, a group of rivers, a group of rivers, that is some rivers, this is collective noun. But another exam, bird, bird, whole word of the bird, that is common noun. But only crow or duil or pigeon, these are proper noun. A flock of birds, this is collective noun. Boy, any boy, boy common noun, but Rohim, Korim, Ram, Sham, these are proper noun. A team of boys, this is collective. So now look, this is a chart and you can see four pictures. Now think and say what do you mean about the picture. Here a guard is taking a smell, a boy is looking, two players are shaking hands, and a family, they are taking their means. But these are concrete noun. Because here in previous time I said you, now look, seen that is this picture, seen, and smelt this first picture, smelled, second picture, seen, third picture, Now look, taste and finally test. These are concrete noun. Four kinds of concrete noun. Proper noun. Proper noun, what is proper noun? A noun that refers to the name of a particular person, place, things and quality. This is proper noun. Suppose persons Rohim, Korim, Meena, Lamia, these are proper noun or persons. Things Quran, Gita, Titanic, these are things. Places Khulna, Dhaka, Gopalganj, India, Pakistan, Nepal, Japan, these are places. Quality. Honesty is the best policy. Here, honesty, quality. Next, proper noun always be capital letter. So, here, now look, yellow color, first, Rahim, here, R, capital. Quran, capital. Khulna, K, capital. These are capital. So, proper noun always be capital. Next, common. A common noun is the given to all things and persons. A common noun is the given to all things and persons. Nazrul is a great poet. Here, poet. Poet is common noun. The rose is a nice flower. Here, flower, common noun. Now, this is a chart and look at the chart. Common noun and proper noun. Common noun, man. Proper noun, Joy, Rohim, Shobuz and Chuan. Common noun, girl. Proper noun, Meena, Lima, Sharmin, Mabia. Common noun, city, Dhaka, London, Delhi. Common noun, river. Proper noun, Padda, Meghna, Yamuna. Common noun, bird. Proper noun, crow, dwell. This is defer, proper and common. Okay. Now look. He is a very honest boy. He is not a dishonest boy at all. Now collective noun. The collective noun that refers to the name of a group of or collection of person or things of the same kind thought of as one divided whole. Now look. You can proper, common and collective noun. Proper noun. Padda, common, river, a group of rivers. Singular number. Collective noun always be singular. Proper, crow, common, bird, a flock of birds and it will be singular. Rohim, proper, common, boy, a team of boys. Here also singular, that is singular verb. Next, material noun or uncountable. Material or uncountable. A material noun is a name which indicates a matter or substance but not indicate any part or number of. After material noun, verb always singular. Now look, water. Water have or has no color of its own. Here, water, singular and material noun. After material noun, verb singular. So, here has, not have. Iron is one of the most useful metals. Here, iron singular, so barb is singular. Okay. Abstract. Next, abstract noun. Now look, abstract noun. What is abstract noun? Abstract noun is that noun which indicates some abstract idea or quality which has no physical existence and cannot be touched, smelled, heard, received through the sense, but can only be imagined. So now look, you can see there are two pictures. First picture, what is the idea about the first picture? Next picture number two, what's your idea about the picture? Now look, the first picture, you can see there are some question mark. What, when, who, why, how, where. If you find this question in a word or a word, this is what kinds of noun? Who can tell me? Or next, a man is thinking something, that is question thinking. What kinds of thinking will be next or what kinds of noun? If you find a what, when, who, why, how, where, this question in a word, this is abstract noun. Sorry, concrete noun. But when you have to think something, that is abstract noun. Now look, another chart, common noun and abstract noun. Common, boy, abstract noun, boyhood. Friend, common, friendship. Man, manhood. Child, childhood. Student, studentship. Friend, friendship. This is abstract noun and these are common. Okay. Now, countable and uncountable noun. Countable, few, a few, the few, many, more, very few, some, several. These are countable noun. These are countable noun. Now look, brother come here. Addressing him as brother, the speaker told or requested his brother to go there. This is countable noun. Now, have you any question? About noun? So, okay. Now, again reflect, any kinds of name is noun. Basically two kinds of noun, abstract noun and concrete noun. Concrete noun, four kinds of concrete noun, proper noun, common noun, collective noun and material noun. Total noun, five kinds of noun. Proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun and abstract noun. What is difference abstract and कॉन्क्रीट नाउन। व्हाट इज डिफरेंट एबस्ट्रैक्ट एंड कॉन्क्रीट नाउन? एबस्ट्रैक्ट नाउन एबस्ट्रैक्ट नाउन दैट इज यू हैव टू सीन बट यू कैन नॉट टच, यू कैन नॉट सी, यू कैन नॉट सी, यू कैन नॉट टच, यू कैन नॉट स्मेल, यू कैन नॉट टेस्ट, दैट इज एबस्ट्रैक्ट नाउन। बट if you see something, if you touch something, if you observe something, this is concrete noun. Four kinds of concrete noun: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, and material noun. Proper noun. Proper noun. Any kinds of name is noun, but only one name is proper noun. Only one name. Suppose a person, a name of a person, Karim, Rahim, Ram, Sham, Jadu, these are proper noun. But when we can say man, whole word of the man, this is common noun. Collective noun, some, or team, or army, or work class, these are collective noun. But material noun, material noun, metals, or substance, that is material noun, like water, sugar, salt, iron, these are material noun. Basically, these things or materials noun always will be word things. Okay, my dear students, if you have any question, please ask question. Next class we'll discuss pronoun. Next class we will discuss pronoun. Okay, my dear students, thank you. Best of all.